Good morning, YouTube. Today, we're gonna go check out the 1961 Ferrari 250 GT California.
The 1961 Ferrari 250 GT California.
It's actually a Modena, and it's the actual car in Ferris Bueller's.
Bueller? Bueller? Bueller.
I am not kidding how this is all happening. Kind of a crazy set of circumstances. My buddy Joe, he owns that car right now, and only for like another couple weeks, because that car is going to auction for Monterey Car Week. So that car is going to be for sale. One of you could actually own the Ferris Bueller's Day Ferrari.
Man with priorities so far out of whack doesn't deserve such a fine automobile.
We're gonna go down to Joe's house, check out this amazing ride with incredible history, and I'm sure learn some interesting information. I am beyond excited. I think this is gonna be the coolest thing we've done in a while. Let's head on down to Joe's house, check out the Ferrari 250 replica. They only made three, two of them actually drove, and this is one of the ones that actually drove. All right, let's get rolling. I had to change into the appropriate attire. Got to represent the Red Wings. Hell yeah.
County here, shoot.
I love the sign.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
I converted this barn to a shop.
I say, did it disappear for a long time?
30-some years. Well, just the guy had it, he bought it, and he just started every once in a while, so yeah.
This is one of the actual ones in the movie, right?
Absolutely.
So there was only two that ran, if I remember right.
Yeah.
Two that ran, one shell, so three total.
There was a stunt, yeah, stunt car and two.
And I was reading that this is the one that they, like, actually did the jumps with, right?
No, that's Neil Glassmoyer, who built these cars, sold that one in 2013. It still had the camera mounts on the frame.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah, so this was interchangeable.
Ah. Talk about cool history, right? Like.
Oh, yeah. They only made about 50 of these total. I had to take all the logos off from the movie, you know, to run it through Mecum. They can't do anything with Ferrari on unless it's a real Ferrari.
Oh, no kidding. What a gorgeous car. This is almost better than having a real 250 because you can drive this. If you have a real 250, you can't drive them because they'll depreciate and you can't touch them. And it's a Ford 351, right?
It's a 5 liter.
A 5 liter is five.
And it's got aluminum heads, roller rockers, you know, obviously downdraft levers. It's about probably 3 1/4 horse, 350. Torque,
for something this light, that's gotta be fun.
2,400 pounds. 50-50 weight distribution.
I guess it is behind the axle, so.
It is a little bit, yeah.
It's probably technically a mid-engine.
Yeah. Tubular steel chassis, hand-built, designed by Bob Webb, who did the Indy cars. I mean, they're fantastic cars. Coilover suspension, independent coilover.
If there is, yeah, oh, of course. Yeah, if only you could have gotten nervous, right?
Who built the car?
Yeah.
He has it. He's bringing it to the auction.
Oh, no way.
The car goes through the auction. He'll have Nervous on it.
That's hilarious.
That's a real play from the movie.
Yeah, Nervous, yeah.
He's donating a bunch of movie memorabilia.
No kidding.
Signed posters from the cast.
Oh, no shit.
I've got a die cast. There's only Ferrari allowed a die cast model of these, you know, built of whatever size they are, you know, the all metal ones. And, they're the only ones that they could do a limited number of them, and then Ferrari shut them off. But these have the Ferrari emblem on them, on the diecast.
No,
so that's
kidding.
Going with the car also.
Wow.
Yeah. So
not only do you get the car, you get the posters, the diecast.
All the memorabilia.
A bunch of memorabilia.
Yeah, I just got it.
Man, someone's gonna snatch this up. What date is it actually auctioned?
It goes on Saturday the 25th.
May have to go see this actually get auctioned.
Yeah,
that would be cool. See, the valve covers are made to look like
just
Ferrari,
like, yeah,
Modena.
Yeah, it would
so
normally
it's,
say.
It's a Modena, but did they have a name for the model?
Yeah, GT Spider California.
They call it GT Spider California?
Absolutely.
Ferrari sued them, and that's why they went under, is they just...
Well, they didn't go under. They sold the after Ferrari sued them, then they sold the company.
There it is. Look at that.
That's cool. And then the build date says 1963 because in California, when they built them, they had to use the date of the engine block, so they're pretty smog.
Given that the age of Ferris Bueller, you know, how many years it's been, I think it's, people want this car.
Yeah.
I mean, this is it's one of the most iconic cars in movie history, right?
100%. It was just inducted into the, well, in April, I think you knew it was inducted into the Smithsonian Historical Vehicle Association. This thing's been all over the media, you know, it's one up for sale.
Well, there's a ton of articles going on about it right now. Yeah, when you said you're selling it and you said it's the Ferris Bueller's car, I didn't think you meant like the actual Ferris Bueller's car. I thought you meant, oh, it's one of the reproductions. No, it's literally the car in the movie.
Yep. So there's only 1,600 miles on the engine. It started right up.
Gotta take advantage of it while you got it, right?
Yeah. Gotta pinch myself. It's real. It's real. This is really happening.
One of these will actually be with the car. They did actually use a 250 for some of the shots from what I was reading.
Yeah. Yeah.
But they used the Mona for the driving and all the other stuff.
All for everything in the movie. Furry and several of their periodicals admitted that movie did more for their car than any other car ever.
Especially the 250.
Yeah. A guy called me and just said, because he knew that, somebody knew that I knew Modenus, you know. Remember when Neil sold the company back in 88?
Okay.
He kept the rights to two cars.
Did you have them build one?
Well, I built one for myself and he built one. We rented a little shop out in El Cajon in East San Diego. And we built two. This was in like late 80s, early 90s.
Okay.
And I had that for a year. And then I sold it to a guy in Germany, went overseas.
Wow.
And then, I always watched the market for him the next, you know, 20, 30 years. And when one would come for sale, I'd check it out. And then I heard about this on the internet, somebody said there's one coming up for sale that's real low mileage, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And it's been sitting for 35 years. I go, well, that sometimes is a problem, but I said, sure, send me pictures. And I saw it, I got the pictures. I immediately sent them to Neil and I go, Neil, is this the original mode? And he goes, yeah, I remember that car. So I bought it, sight unseen, and shipped it from where I bought it to Scottsdale where Neil was.
Yeah.
And then he started doing I begged and pleaded and said, could you please restore the car? Because nobody knows the car better than you do. And he says, I think this might be one of the movie cars. So he dug out all of his old records and receipts. Dave Turley built the chassis.
Yeah.
And he stamped the frames on the early cars. So it had DT0003 on it, on that frame. So he goes, this was one of the three movie cars.
Holy crap. That's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Were you around when they were building the originals for the movie?
Yeah. I met Neil. Sure. I met Neil. I moved to Denver early 85 and they had the shop out there and had just built the cars, I think, for the movies. But they were still building the cars, you know, just for production, hand building them one at a time. Whoever bought the car could put the Ferrari emblem on.
But Mona probably couldn't.
Mona could not put the Ferrari emblem on. But as soon as it went out the door, they could put the
Ferrari. Yeah, of course, everyone did.
You know, I did instantly.
Yeah. Yeah.
And this one, like I said, comes with all the original Ferrari badging on it that goes on.
Wow.
Yeah, it's part of me is hard to sell.
Yeah, I bet, right? You got a history with it.
People have no idea. You rode in it.
It's a great car. It really is.
It's a fantastic driving car.
Yeah.
And reliable. You could drive that thing across country, literally. Yeah,
huge thanks to Joe. What a cool car, cool history. I knew he knew stuff about them. I didn't realize he actually like helped build them and actually knows the guy that made them. One of three that they made for the movie, one of two that actually ran. It's not the one that did the jumps. It's the one that they did some of the other cuts with. Unbelievable story behind it. Sat for basically like 35 years and they found it and he had it restored and it runs and drives beautifully. Some lucky suckers gonna get that car at the Mecham auction at Monterey and they're gonna be really happy. I really appreciate you guys for watching. Hopefully that was exciting for you guys as it was for me. What a cool experience. I can't stop smiling, man. What a cool day. All right, we're gonna go have some lunch. So I'm gonna stop filming. You guys are amazing. Thank you for watching. Subscribe, watch that video, give me the thumbs up. Share this video, help Joe get the word out that this thing's gonna be for sale August 25th. It's gonna go on the block. So if you want it, talk to Mecham. All right, we'll see you soon. We'll be doing more car stuff. It's gonna be sweet.
Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.